Our lab has studied the genetic differences between males and females for decades.
Understanding those differences could show why certain conditions, such as heart disease or lupus, are more common in one sex than another. Many researchers study these sex biases by investigating one condition in detail.
We thought to take a completely different approach, to start not with the disease endpoints, but to simply assert that there must exist molecular differences between males and females across the body, potentially in every cell type, and that coming to a basic and fundamental understanding of those molecular differences would prove powerful in the context of any sex-biased disease setting.
The researchers asked how gene expression differs between males and females throughout the body, including in the heart, skin, and brain.
So we looked at gene expression in 12 organs in 5 different species: human, monkey, mouse, rat, and dog, really span much of the breadth of mammalian evolution. They have a last common ancestor that lived about 80 or 100 million years ago.
Looking at this group of species would let the scientists know whether the sex biases had evolved long ago or had arisen more recently in primates or in humans.
What really caught our eye was that we could find conserved sex-biased gene expression in every organ we looked at, which is pretty exciting. And at the same time, we found that the majority of the sex-biased gene expression had evolved more recently. One of the big next steps is to figure out, do these differences in gene expression between the sexes, do they actually matter?
As a test case, the researchers looked at one of the most intensely studied genetic traits, height. While the distributions of heights in males and females overlap, there's about a 13-centimeter difference in average height.
My graduate student Sahin Naqvi thought that perhaps conserved sex-biased gene expression might manifest in part in this larger height or size in males as compared to females. In what was for us a very surprising, stunning and exciting explanation for 12% of the 13-centimeter shift.
This finding showed the researchers that the sex-biased gene expression can affect a male-female difference in a trait.
It's important because it validates the functional significance of the sex-biased gene expression. There are functional consequences. We operate with a sort of a unisex view of human biology, and I think that ignores the stark reality that health and disease play out very differently in XX and XY individuals.